This creature, called a coconut crab, inhabits the Ryukyu Islands of Japan's Okinawa Prefecture. It can open hard coconuts with its powerful claws. Their force is equivalent to a lion's bite. We at NIMS have focused our attention on these coconut crabs in a search for clues on the development of unconventional materials. Our unique analytical techniques and the creativity of our researchers enabled us to discover an amazing spiral microstructure and a double-layered structure typically seen in Japanese swords. These are the secrets to the coconut crab's outstanding abilities. In this video, we show how a material scientist became interested in coconut crabs and uncovered its secrets using an approach completely different from that of a biologist. This is a coconut crab. You may not have seen one. It's so strong that it can break coconut shells. The pinching force of the claws in a 2-kilogram coconut crab is about 180-kilogram force. What questions do you have after seeing this mighty performance? Perhaps you want to know what makes this marvelous power possible. One of our researchers thought about it differently. This is Dr. Tadanobu Inoue, working on metal materials. His first question upon seeing the claws of a coconut crab was how they can withstand such large loads without failing. He obtained a biological specimen of a coconut crab and examined it from a material scientist viewpoint. First of all, he measured the hardness of the claw's shell. In materials science, hardness is determined by the crack size made in a material when a diamond tip is impressed into it under a certain load. Let's look at the claw's surface afterwards. From this crack size, the hardness is calculated to be 250 HV. This is as hard as steel. It's incredible. Meanwhile, hard materials are generally known to be brittle in materials science. How can coconut crab claws endure such heavy loads? Dr. Inoue noticed the microstructure of the claws. Metals consist of combinations of many microcrystals, and a metal's hardness varies with their size. For example, iron containing fine crystals is hard, while iron consisting of larger microcrystals deforms more easily. What kind of microstructure is found in the claws? Let's look at them through a special microscope called PFIB-SEM, originally developed by NIMS. This microscope takes a series of sequential photographs while scraping the surface to obtain a 3D map of a material's microstructure. The claw's shell consists of thin, striped plates stacked in a spiral configuration. The thickness of the plate is about 2.5 micrometers. The total number of plates is about 100. This structure resembles plywood, in which layers of wood are arranged with grain running perpendicular to one another to increase strength. Can we reinforce materials by introducing staggered fibrous layers? Dr. Inoue has researched microstructures in an effort to develop hard, tough materials for 20 years. In 2008, he succeeded in producing a tough metal with a fibrous microstructure that resists complete breakage. This bamboo-like metal received widespread attention. However, he has never been satisfied with extending existing approaches in materials science. After a long search, he found a big hint in biological research on coconut crabs. He was finally able to identify the spiral microstructure in the shells of coconut crabs. In fact, Dr. Inoue found one more important thing upon his first examination. The crab's shell consists of three layers. The outermost layer is the hardest, and the innermost layer is softer but tougher. This configuration is also seen in Japanese swords. In order to prevent breakage when swords cross, this combination is needed. This is also the case in coconut crab claws. Dr. Inoue then became interested in the intermediate layer. If we join two metals that differ in hardness, the joint becomes very fragile. Thus, he believed that some hints for developing novel materials can be revealed by examining the structure and properties of this intermediate layer.
かなりワクワク感が出てきて、もっとちょっと追求してみて、実際にどういうふうにこれがなってるかっていうのを、今のある科学技術でちょっと調べてみて、で、それによってこれを何か新しいものづくりに生かせないかなっていうのはずっと考えて。